Good morning. Good morning. And welcome to the final session of our induction weekend. I now call to order the 2044th stated meeting of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. Well, it's been a wonderful weekend, and I hope you found it as inspiring and uplifting and as fun as I have. As you know by now, there are many ways to participate in the life of the Academy, and we encourage you, each of you, to be active. So please keep in touch. I'd like to hear from each of you in the year ahead and hope that we can find opportunities to get together. As you've seen, our induction weekend is an elaborate undertaking requiring a very precise choreography. And so I want to take a moment to thank the Academy staff for their efforts to make this weekend as welcoming, as substantive, as seamless as possible. Every staff member at the Academy has played an important role in planning and organizing these programs, and so please join me in thanking them for their hard work and dedication. Will the staff come forward? They're behind you. And a special call out to Mark Robinson and Judith Polgar, who have borne a great, heavy responsibility among all the others. After we hear from Temple Grandin, she will take some questions, and then we will adjourn about 11 o'clock to the atrium and enjoy a brunch and one last time to be with each other on this wonderful weekend. In the 1783 Memoirs of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences, our very first publication, Academy Fellow Cotton Tufts, a physician and Massachusetts State Senator, contributed an essay entitled An Account of the Horn Distemper in Cattle, with observations on that disease. Think of that, the very first publication of the Academy. That such an article would be included among the Academy's initial scholarly offerings is evidence of the importance of animal science to the young nation. The United States was of necessity an agrarian nation in 1783, and any disease that struck the crop of land, livestock posed an existential threat. Horn distemper was a potentially fatal disease that attacked the pith of the horn, the internal substance, before spreading to the cattle's brain. It was contagious enough to threaten entire herds. Tufts likened the disease to smallpox and believed that, like smallpox, it thrived in close quarters. It was a thoroughly modern disease, a result of overcrowding. Here's what he wrote. Beast of the forest, guided by the dictates of nature, and uncontrolled by man in their food, air, exercise, and rest, are seldom affected with any disease, whilst in almost all countries, the domestic kind, that are more immediately under the government of man, are subject to a variety of diseases. Well, in the tradition of Cotton Tufts and many of the earliest Academy Fellows, our speaker this morning has spent the better part of her career studying animal behavior, countering the effects of human error, and advocating for the healthy and humane treatment of the animals we depend upon for food and other forms of life. Temple Grandin is an assistant professor of animal science at Colorado University and a leading designer of livestock handling facilities. Over half the cattle in the U.S., and Canada are corralled and sorted in plants that she has helped design. She's also been a consultant for major food corporations, developing animal welfare guidelines for familiar chains like McDonald's, Wendy's, and Burger King. Nature is cruel, she has written, but we don't have to be. Professor Grandin also has autism. Born in Boston, she learned to speak very slowly, and only after her parents insisted that she be admitted for speech therapy. She went on to earn a BA from Franklin Pierce College, a master's degree from Arizona State, and a doctorate from the University of Illinois. Ultimately, she discovered that autism was less of a burden than a characteristic that made her special. "Who do you think invented the first stone spear?" she asks. "It wasn't the people chit-chatting around the fire. It was the Aspergers." Today, she credits autism as a source of her insights into animal behavior. She has also drawn on her experience as a scientist to comment and advocate for children with autism, many of whom, with proper support, can be future Temple Grandins. She is author of a dozen books, including Animals in Translation, Animals Make Us Human, The Learning Style of People with Autism, an autobiography, and Thinking in Pictures, Other Reports from My Life with Autism. She was awarded the 2011 Double Helix Medal for positively impacting human health and has been listed among Time Magazine's 100 most influential people. She was also the subject of an Emmy-winning HBO movie, Temple Grandin, starring Claire Danes, which many of you have probably seen. So join me in welcoming our very special guest, Temple Grandin.